President Zelensky, how did the meeting go, sir?
Very good.
Ukraine's president pleading for more support at a time when commitments by some are wavering. Vladimir Zelensky mingled with the business and political elite in Davos, Switzerland, at the World Economic Forum. In his speech, he urged countries to pass more punishing sanctions.
Putin loves money above all. The more billions he and his oligarchs, friends, and accomplices lose, the more likely he will regret starting this war.
Nearly 2 years into Russia's full-scale invasion, there are no signs that Vladimir Putin is prepared to pull back. It's quite obvious, he said. Not only did Ukraine's counteroffensive fail, but the initiative is completely in the hands of the Russian armed forces. In the eastern Ukrainian city of Donetsk, which Russia and local separatists seized back in 2014, a small but apparently enthusiastic group lined up to pledge their support for Putin, who will run and almost certainly win the presidential election again. We are doing this absolutely voluntarily, said one man. We are here to sign our support. And there was another show of cooperation in Moscow from a country that Russia increasingly relies on. North Korea's foreign minister visited the Kremlin. The U.S. and Ukraine have accused Pyongyang of supplying Russia with weapons, including ballistic missiles, which hit Kharkiv earlier this month. Ukraine says it's running short on ammunition and missile defense systems.
We're working to secure bipartisan support for the necessary resources to supply Ukraine with the weapons it needs.
But for now, that $60 billion aid package remains stalled in Congress. As for the European Union, it says Ukraine will receive the $50 billion it promised, even if Hungary keeps blocking the move. Briar Stewart, CBC News, London.